Hello there, many thanks for keeping us company. And if you just tuned in, this is Y254 Discussion Monday now. And we are talking about the global warming because we have seen a series of natural calamities in our countries, that is flooding and as well as drought and famine and floods as well. So I am joined by Sheila Mukamie. She's the president of Kenya Medical Training Institute College, right? All right, and thank you for being part of us tonight. Now, before we took that break, we talked about the deforestation, and there's an MP was saying, what's the relationship between rain and trees? I don't know, me back in school, I was told trees are catchment area for rains. Were you told the same thing?
Trees act as a water catchment area because when you cut down the trees, we like affecting the normal circulation of air and everything that goes on in the okay, as we talk about weather, when we're talking about cutting down of trees, when we just even compare places that trees that are grown, like we shall compare an example of the western part of Kenya,
true,
and we compare, and even Limuru, mm-hmm, as we compare to Kambani and Turkana, where there are no trees, mm-hmm, we'll see like these people are suffering from drought. Mm-hmm. We'll see that these people are not having enough food. We'll see these people are having a lot of famine. So when we come back to these places where there are a lot of trees, like the western part of Kenya, Limuru, Trans Nzoia, uh-huh, that is, yeah. When we see that these are places where we grow food.
True.
And now when we compare these two parts, we see there are a lot of trees in the western side of Kenya and there are no trees in the northeastern side of Kenya. So that's why we'll take agriculture to that place because there'll be a lot of rains.
Right.
Yeah, as compared to Turkana and Ukambani.
All right, for the last like say 7 years, there has been proposals for projects to have dams constructed in such areas like Baringo and the rest. Mm-hmm. Actually, Baringo has been hard hit with famine this year because the rains have been delayed in a way, and it could be attributed to global warming. Mm-hmm. But in the same vein, we have seen government's efforts to ensure that it's habitats are safe from farming, from dying from farming and maybe the flooding, because we don't know what will happen this year. Last year we lost so many people through flooding, mm-hmm, and now such projects that have been proposed, for an example the dams, and then we had the Northern Collector Tunnel that was to harness the waters. Mm-hmm. Now you as a Kenyan, what do you feel should have been done more, and is it timely because we are continuing losing people because of such events?
As a Kenyan and a youth in that matter, what I can see is the government should come down to back to us and involve us in decision making, whereby they can build the dams, yes, they will help us. But now what about the long time factors that can help us? And when I look at the long time factors that can help us, I look at us being educated on, okay, you're doing 1, 2, 3, and this is going to cause drought in this place, this is going to cause famine, this is going to cause you not to plant even agricultural crops in the near future.
True.
So if you came back to us at the ground and told us that you, Sheila, as a human being, in your own compound, you should estimate like you're supposed to plant this number of trees according, mm-hmm, to the number of acreage that you have, mm-hmm, so that every Kenyan can have that target to plant a tree, because when you plant trees, we are looking at the long-term factor that, mm-hmm, will help us and benefit all of us and even the people that are coming after us. Mm-hmm. We can look at dams, but dams come, they are man-made. These, sure, are things which will come down and fall one day. Mm-hmm. These are things like we can look at the dams that we have in Kenya. Are all of them operating?
Sure.
And are they serving the basic factor that they were created to do? Mm-hmm. They are not helping all the Mwananchis. But if we come back to this, we'll help a bigger population, and it will serve for a long
time. I remember the heroine, the late Wangari Maathai. She was so adamant to ensure that we have conserved our environment. And I have seen most of us Kenyans, if not all, we continue destroying our environment. Speak of cutting trees. People have been encouraged of agroforestry. I don't know, for the last, say, 5 years, I don't know what has happened, because I remember back in school, we used to be encouraged to plant a tree every single public holiday. Mm-hmm. Is this thing continuing? And we were looking at 10% of Kenya's land having trees. Mm-hmm. Are we near getting to that 10% like China?
Okay. I look at Wangari Maathai and I see her as a an icon to emulate at this time, because when she was alive, we could plant trees and she could ensure that the trees that were planted could grow. But now, today we'll have the environmental day in Kenya, we'll have the several environmental days in several institutions, and people will be planting the trees. But now, are we looking after the trees that we've planted? We're just planting it for show off.
Right.
We've planted trees, it's an environmental day, trees are supposed to be planted, but are we looking after those trees so that they can grow? People will cut down trees. We are telling them, cut one, plant three. Mm-hmm. But are they following that today?
Right.
So we're still a long way back, in fact, to achieving what is supposed to be done unless we start practicing what we are saying.
All right. There was a rundown between the people of Rift Valley and Narok, if I'm not wrong, about the Mau Forest. This thing was politicized because they couldn't understand the relation between the forest and the rains. A group of people believed rains are a blessing from God.
Mm-hmm.
And now it has continued to bring this havoc in the country, like the famine, because the rains are not here. And if they come, they come late. And when they come with a massacre message, that is, people will die because of flooding. We have seen soil degradation because of this. Now, what more do you think should be done for the public education to ensure that even if the trees have been cut, how else could you manage the environment that you live in?
Okay, it's not about even the trees alone, because there is a lot of issues. Like I can say, thanks to NEMA, right now we do not have plastic bags, because plastic bags are also a menace to the environment sector. But now we are looking at, we've done away with the plastic bags. What are we doing about the plastic bottles that we are using?
Actually, they are the most now blocking the sewerage now.
Yeah, I can look at Coca-Cola and say that I'm going to give them like a thumbs up, because just there 2 days ago I've seen them, they've started using Dasani and they're putting them in a glass bottle. Yeah, we can still go that way to help our environment. It's not about the trees alone, but we can also check on the things that we are using for our homes, like the bottles that we're taking for water. Many companies that are coming up to sell water, the bottled water, they should now also change to the glass, so that we can avoid the blockage in the sewerage. We can also open our drainage systems so that we cannot have the waters that are going to be stagnant in most places.
True.
Mm-hmm.
That's a very good move. Now let's talk about the industries. You just mentioned one company, but now we have fumes emitted by industries as one of the contributing factors to global warming, apart from greenhouse and every other thing else. But then, how do we ensure the byproducts from these companies will not come to destroy our environment? Because it has been said time and again, and we have seen rules, we have seen laws being brought on board to ensure that such industries, they will manage their waste. But now that hasn't happened. And if it has happened, it hasn't gone anywhere. What more do you think should be done?
Okay, about the industries that are producing things which are environment unfriendly, I guess we can go back to these companies and talk to them and give them the information that we have as the environmentalists in Kenya today. We can talk to them. Like, I've used an example of Coca-Cola. They were using the plastic bottles for storage of water, the water that they're selling, but now they are changing into the glass. Now we can go back and say that they should start using environment friendly products that will help our community, so that even after using these, we can get, like, even if they'll still use the plastic bottles that you are using today, we can still get back these bottles and reuse them so that they are not thrown, and we can get them all over the places. We can even get the kanjo. They are here in Kenya today, but they're only looking at things that are benefiting them.
True.
If we could get the kanjos enforcing rules about our environment today, like if I see someone throwing a plastic bottle somewhere, they can even be arrested, they can even be taken or charged as something, so that they can know this is our environment and we're protecting it for us.
Right.
These industries that we are going to use, we can tell them that if you're going to produce this stuff, we need you to also give us a way in which they are going to be disposed of. Because if you're not going to produce them, then you're like an environment hazard to us.
Sure.
And you're going to cost our lives tomorrow, so you need to carbon you.
Actually, speaking about losing our lives, global warming has brought about the famine we can see in our country, and it's not only in Kenya, but it has been happening even to other nations. But speaking of our country, just this year we had famine in Turkana, and we had people, we had all manner of reports. There are people who have died, there are people who have not died. So one of the big four agendas of this regime currently in office is about food security. Mm-hmm. As we wind up, because time is not on our side now, food security, we don't have rains, we don't have dams for irrigation, we have nothing. We only rely on the rains that will come. Mm-hmm. And the rains will be late. And at times when they come, they will not be there, as in it will take a short time. Taking an example of the southern Kenya, the rains will come and they will like go, they will not be harnessed. These people, how do we encourage Kenyans to use what they have, like if it's farming, sustainable food growing, and the methods that will ensure you're not only planting food for the stomach, but also you're looking into the future? How do we do this?
Okay, a few years ago, there was agriculture being taught in primary schools. And this was helping because there are 4K clubs that were being formed, and these pupils at a tender age, they were taught on what to plant even in their environment according to the places they are living. Now, if we brought back a subject like agriculture, or if it cannot be brought back, we could even go back to the communities down there. We can go back to Turkana, we can go to Ukambani and teach these people, these are the certain produce, these are the certain foods that can be grown in this area. Right. You know, it's not that these places cannot completely raise any agricultural products. Sure. They can plant there, like there are places in Baringo where you can water the area and you can plant even maize.
Sure.
So we've not taught them about any irrigation schemes that they can use. You cannot teach them about any methods that they can use even to plant today, and you expect them to use. Mm-hmm. These people don't have the knowledge.
All right.
It still comes back to civic education. We need to go down and educate these people on what they're supposed to do. We cannot just leave them mm-hmm. and expect water to me akilizao, and then they'll do that. So we need, as a government, we need to go down and break it down to them, to go back, even if it's house to house, and educate them. Mm-hmm. Because this is something that today we are talking about famine, tomorrow we're talking about loss of massive lives in Kenya.
True.
So we can prevent that by starting to teach them. You cannot, if you cannot plant, you're a person who is rearing cattle, you can still sell these and get the plants that you get.
True.
Another thing is lowering the prices of the foods that we have in Kenya today. Mm. We've raised the prices for these foods that people can, the local mananchi cannot afford it. Mm-hmm. So even the farmers, the few farmers that are selling the maize, wamekatilia their maize because zinatoka at a very low price, they cannot even get the profits. Mm-hmm. Why are we now raising it to that extent that hawa now watashindwa hata kuuza and get the profit that they need?
True. Actually, it's very sad because I hear some of the farmers are hoarding their maize because they want the government, if they to buy at a good price. Mm-hmm. Now, we are out of time. If you could give us now your final recommendation in regards to this issue, like global warming, how do we do, how moving forward, what should we do?
Moving forward as a country, we should go back to civic education. That's public education. Mm-hmm. If we can go back and educate these people on the impacts of what we are doing to our environment today, and the impacts that they can bring in the next few years that are going to come, mm-hmm. these people can get the knowledge and they can be able at an individual point, they can still come down and curb the problem that is.
Actually, you're speaking of education, and I'm like, the curriculum is being changed. I don't know what it will have in it, because you spoke of the 4K club. I remember I was part of it back in school. But anyway, many thanks for coming and sharing your comments and your opinions. We are out of here because time is not on our side, but coming up next is Why Mashariki. I am told Zimenishika will be around, so keep it Y254. She has been my guest, Sheila. All right, many thanks back home. Thank you for keeping us company. I'll see you on Friday. Have a good night.